Hi, this is Jason with Origin Electrical. Today I'm going to show you how to install a Nest thermostat. Most of what I show you here should apply to other smart thermostats like the Ecobee or the Honeywell T5, especially the way the wiring goes in and everything like that. But there may be some differences in how you actually configure it. So you can actually, you know, expect a video on those devices in the future. So right now, let's just get right to it. I'll show you how to install a Nest. Installation is actually pretty straightforward. Before you go ahead and purchase your Nest thermostat though, you're going to want to make sure it works with the system that you have. Nest, as well as the other smart thermostat manufacturers, usually have a good compatibility checker on their website. I'll actually go ahead and put a link for the Nest one in the description below. But there's three main things that you want to check to make sure it's going to work. The first thing being that your current system, your furnace system, is not a line voltage system, meaning that it runs off 120 volts. It needs to be a 24 volt AC system. You're going to want to make sure that you don't have stranded wires in the wall. Actually, when I went to go install my Nest thermostat, the previous owner had installed the old thermostat using stranded speaker wire. So I actually had to go through, pull out that wire, and install a proper solid core thermostat wire that's 18 gauge. The third thing you're going to want to make sure is that it's not going to work with a fan coil system. Specifically, if you see when you take off the cover of your old thermostat, a terminal where a wire is connected to an H2O or water terminal, that means your system's not going to work. So I'm actually going to show you how to check and make sure your Nest should be compatible. So let's obviously my Nest is already installed, but let's just assume this is actually my old thermostat. You're going to take off the faceplate, have a look at the wires. Notice that these wires are actually small, solid core, 18 gauge wires, okay? That's usually going to indicate that it's a 24 volt system and it'll work. Like I said, on a rare occasion, there may be the wrong wires, stranded wires installed, and you may have to replace the wire, but it should work fine. If you see wires that are thick, like this, like these 14 gauge wires, that means that your system is a line voltage 120 volt system. Your Nest thermostat won't work. One thing you can do is using a multimeter, if you either have one or are willing to go to a hardware store and buy one, and you can actually get them for fairly cheap if you just buy a lower end one, it'll work just fine, is you can actually take the red wire, which is actually your hot, and then any of the other wires, and connect your multimeter to it. I don't know if you can see that. I'm getting 28.75 volts. And that means it's a low voltage system. Yeah. It still means it's a 24 volt system, but sometimes they actually indicate they're a little bit higher. So you know your Nest thermostat is going to work. The other thing you can do is actually go down to your furnace here, take off the cover plate, and test the voltage across the terminals on your control board. Is actually put your multimeter across two of the leads down here. So again, one of your leads across the R terminal, and then any of the other leads, and then you should get, give or take, 24 volts, and that's how you know you have the proper system. Now, if you know you've got the right system, you've bought your unit, everything, you're ready to go, what you're going to want to do is turn off the power leading to your furnace. I forgot to mention, when you're at your furnace, go ahead and take a picture of the terminations at your furnace's control board, just in case you need to reference it later. Do the same thing with the base plate at your own old thermostat to make sure you have you know what color goes with what terminal, and then you're ready to install. So once you've taken that picture, go ahead and pull the wires out of all of the terminals. You can remove your base plate, put on your new Nest thermostat base plate, make sure it's level and everything like that, and go ahead and put all the wires in the same letter terminals as they were with your old thermostat. The only thing else you need to keep in mind is that your red, well, hopefully it's red. Sometimes whoever installed it may not have the proper colors. That's why it's important to take a picture of your old setup as well as the terminations at your control board, because the lettering should be the same. But your red, or the wire that was formerly attached to the R terminal on your old thermostat, can either attach to RC or RH. If you have a humidifier or a dehumidifier or other auxiliary equipment, you can actually go ahead and attach it to the star terminal. Once you're done that, you can attach your faceplate. After your faceplate is on, you can come back downstairs, close up your furnace, and turn the power back on. The most important thing when installing a Nest thermostat or any other smart thermostat is making sure the wires are on the same terminals on the new thermostat as they were on the old thermostat. Every once in a while, you can actually run into problems if you only have two wires coming to your thermostat. Sometimes the lack of a common wire can cause problems or cause your furnace to exhibit some weird behavior. Also, if you have a heat pump system, it's possible you might need some additional configuration. I'm going to go over those issues in a later video, but for now, happy nesting. Hope everything worked out for you. For more tutorials and features, please visit our blog at originelectrical.ca.